Welcome to the Introduction to Show Control. This video outlines the features of the Show Control software. Dectronic Show Control is a powerful user-friendly control software interface. Show Control works in conjunction with other hardware components, including DMP 7000 and DMP 8000, as well as other equipment such as video processors. Show Control operates over an Ethernet network connection to control your Dectronics displays. Show Control consists of two separate programs, Display Studio and Content Studio. Display Studio is used to trigger content to the displays during an event. Content Studio is used as a content compositor prior to an event. Launch Display Studio by clicking on the desktop icon. When Display Studio launches, you're taken into a workspace. Users can create multiple workspaces if desired. This is helpful for venues that are home to multiple teams or sports so that operators don't interfere with each other's workspaces. In the upper left corner is the Hub or the File menu where common menu items are accessed. These items include New, Open, Save, Close, and Help. You'll also see options such as Assign Service Configuration Setting and Software License Details. The monitor wall allows users to see content playing out to the various displays or zones. This non-frame accurate rendering provides a visual of the content along with a color-coded playback behavior light and timecode. The large space in the middle section of the screen holds the workspace pages. Within a page, containers are created to hold buttons. The main container types are scripting and quick display. Buttons are made by the user and are placed in these containers for easy access during an event. Containers can also be separated into tabs to further organize the workspace. In the lower left corner of the screens is the status indicator light. This offers a quick reference to Show Control's communication to the attached devices. Clicking the status light reveals a window with diagnostics and communication information. Click the arrows to scroll through each device to see status information. Widgets at the bottom of the screen allow for quick on-the-fly control of items such as display brightness, stat monitoring, and audio. The number of widgets in your system will vary based on your system's configuration. This concludes the Display Studio portion of this video. To access Content Studio, click on the pencil icon in the top right corner of the screen. Notice there is no currently open file and most of the options are unavailable. The Hub in the upper left corner contains common functions including New, Open, Save, as well as the Batch Conversion tool and the options for Content Studio. Create a new file by selecting New. When creating a new file or opening an existing one, first select Display, then choose from the list of available display zones in your system. The Basic Functions tab along with the top contain editing options within the upper ribbon. The canvas on the right side of the screen represents the display zone you have selected. The Home tab contains basic functions including font, layout, and paragraph properties. It's also home to quick insert including media items and text boxes. Under the Insert tab, you'll find options for inserting a picture, video, text box, or real-time data such as time and date. Note that only systems that have a temperature sensor installed can use the temperature option. The Format tab contains fill colors, gradient options, borders, and alignment and layering options. Transitions between layouts are found under the Layout tab. You can hover over each transition to see a brief description. Finally, the View tab has zoom buttons and preview controls. The same controls are also located in the bottom right corner of your screen for easy access. Located on the left side of the screen is the Dynamic Data Library. It's used to place real-time data or RTD, such as statistics, onto the layout. This feature is primarily used for sports venues where other stat software is installed. We'll demonstrate the use of this feature in later videos. The timeline across the bottom shows a visual representation of the project layout as well as the elements in that particular layout, similar to video editing software. The timeline has a dedicated zoom bar to get a closer or broader look at the timing of the elements. The Layout Storyboard tab provides a different view of the layout. Adding multiple layouts to a single presentation creates different frames with unique content. The hourglass represents where transition effects can be added if desired. This concludes the introduction to show control. Continue to other videos to learn more about your Tektronix control system.